Oh, well, well done. We're also joined by a TalkSport legend, Ronnie Irani, who is also involved at this football club. What exactly do you do?
I'm just Steve Smith's mate, one of his best mates, him and Ian Twinley. So, they asked me to get involved last year and just be around the lads, and I sit in board meetings and we just... Listen, I just do a little bit. Steve will be able to tell you, I guess, what other stuff I do, but it's just nice to be involved with sport, Adrian, especially what's happened. Essex County Cricket Club, naturally, chairman of cricket there. We've had a brilliant 4 or 5 years. And it's just passing on, you know, sport in any game is similar, okay? Now, anybody can spot talent. Talent spotting is the easiest thing possible, but it's going attitude spotting, and that's where you have to have a gift. So going around, Steve's done that. He's assembled a team of guys who've got a wonderful attitude. Some that have had a little taste of, you know, professional football. Some that haven't. Some that probably should have done. Never got the luck. Some that got the injuries. We know all about that. And then you get them. Have they still got the right attitude and desire to do the best they possibly can at whatever they are? And he's put a great set of lads together. And yeah, I just get involved with the team, you know, home and away. In the dressing room with the lads, and listen, he's a mate of mine, and it's just nice to be involved, and it's going to be a wonderful day for us today, isn't it?
And you might as well get it in, Ron. You sponsor the stadium, don't you?
Yeah, we do sponsor the stadium.
What's it called?
Well, it's the R&D Advisors UK Stadium. Don't dump that, please. Don't dump that. Josh isn't with us anymore, is he? But R&D Advisors UK Stadium, it's something that... Just listen, everybody's got a budget, and we just needed to help out a little bit from that aspect. And we've put a few systems in place, Darren, which I won't divulge. We've got to keep that to ourselves, Steve. But it's working all right so far, so good, Adrian. So,
well, you're at a level in the pyramid, aren't you, where you are allowed to have fans in. St Albans come here tonight, they're a step up, and they're not allowed to have fans in, not allowed to bring fans here tonight either. So it's great that fans can come in to watch the game tonight, but the whole thing, what's your take on it, Steve?
I'm bemused by it, really. I just, the world we're living in at the moment, I think... Yeah, we can have 600 fans. You say St Albans come here, can't have any. If we'd have produced St Albans away tonight, it would have been behind closed doors. So they're streaming it at their clubhouse tonight. It's sad, really. I think that they can't bring people here tonight to watch their team play. But you've got to respect the guidelines of what the government have put in place. We're thankful that we can have 600 people here tonight, and I'm a little bit, as I say, a little bit bemused by it all, really, and the way that things work out. But there's nothing we can do about that. We're thankful that we've got 600 here tonight, and be a good atmosphere, be a good game, hopefully be a good advert for non-league football, and everyone can have a smile on their face, because a lot of people haven't got smiles on their faces at the moment.
What sort of crowds do you normally get here, Steve, on a normal game, if you would normally be playing?
Well, last year when we were struggling, Darren, but probably we was getting 230, 240. They've been going up this year to sort of 350s, 400s. We've had over 400. I think the more we keep winning, the crowds will go up. I think there's a limit on what we'll get here. I don't think we'll ever get sort of 1,500, 2,000, but I think we could probably get up to 650, 700 if we're successful. Obviously, this is great having you guys here today, BT Sport here, giving us good coverage. You know, it's going to be good for us and put us on the map, and it's good publicity and great for the club.
Wonderful.
Well, it is. And I mean, the FA Cup, everybody talks about the magic of the Cup. We've been talking about it on the show, haven't we? And it's still there. Even though it's the qualifying round, it's still there, Ronnie. Now, if you do get into the first round proper and you have a home tie, I'm assuming you can have fans here for that tie. So, I mean, that could be absolutely magnificent for this club.
Yeah, it could be. You know, these are real people, Adrian. Honestly, you turn up... Listen, Steve's played himself a little bit. You know, him and Ian Twin, the most successful, you know, guys involved in East Anglia business-wise. They love the sport, and they invest their time and energy into sport. You know, they were doing this roof, as you said earlier, and the involvement with the club is, it's just real. It's real. And, you know, some of these footballers, we've got some good young players, one of them on Peterborough United's books.
Archie Jones.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He's a good little player. And we sincerely want him. You know, Steve getting involved with him and his family come down here. You know, we want him to be a stepping stone to great things. We all want that. Mm. And that's what sport is about, you know. Naturally, you know, there's some guys there that have done well. They didn't quite make it for whatever reason. But they're here and they give it everything. And it would be, yeah, great for us to win. But it's about the game today. And, you know, getting involved is just lovely.
And, Ron, your involvement, obviously you've been coming down here. We spoke not long ago and you were saying that you've come down here a few times.
I come to training. I do training now, Steve, don't I?
Like I said, you definitely need earphones on if he comes down to training. You won't need a tannoy. But when it comes to fans in at the ground, Ron, you've seen it.
Yep.
As a Man United fan, which I want to know, everybody knows you're a Man United fan, it must be frustrating you as a fan to see where you can come here, because it's not an elite club, class is non-elite, and you can see 600 fans, yet you have a massive stadium like Old Trafford, and you can't have one person in.
Great question. I mean, the time and energy and the effort that gets put into sort of move within the guidelines that have been recommended here, honestly, these guys are working 24/7, not just for this game, guys, but they've been doing it for all the games. You know, the distance and social distance, the masks, everyone will get temperature tested before they enter the ground. Every single fan and supporter. Now, if you did the math, 600 people here, there's a 3,500, then you're sort of saying on a 60,000 seater, you're looking at 15,000 fans technically would be allowed if you did the maths, right? You know, give and take a bit. But on 15,000 people, you're going to have to temperature test every single one of them. What about if one of them's slightly over their temperature and he kicks off because they had a few beers? It's difficult to manage from that situation. So I understand the football stadium where the conundrum can be. And certainly they kind of go, oh, do you know what? We don't need that right now because that could be more trouble than what it's worth. But if you have the manpower, and everyone here, Steve will tell me, the volunteers that get behind the local area here for this to happen is phenomenal. And we've had guys coming round COVID checking that we're doing the right things all the time from the league. And they've said, yeah, flying colours every single time. The hand sanitizer all the way through. If you be sensible and you're smart, we still have to live. We still got to get in with our lives, but we have to respect the guidelines, you know, the rules and regulations that you've got to do, but make it happen. Make it happen. That is what, part of our duty is living. While we are still living, respect what's happened. There's been many people who've been ill. There's lives been lost. Understand all that. Digest it, but come out with what we're going to do about it. Yeah. Don't just sit back and say, what are we going to do? What is the action? And then get on with it.
Should be running the country, Ronnie Irani. Ronnie
speaks like that.
I do fancy it, to be honest. I'm the man of the people.
Well, you're rough it. Running Essex County Cricket, Bishop Stortford FC, sort of.
And the winning. Hey, you've got off to a great start this season, haven't you?
As well.
So it's a great start to the season. You're going into this game full of confidence.
Yeah, full of confidence. I mean, we're 9 games unbeaten. So the boys are buzzing. You know what sport's like there. You get on a run. Winning becomes habit, losing becomes habit, and we're in good place at the moment. So, but tonight, you know, we're playing a team that's a step above us.
Yeah, they've had a good start as well.
So, you know, people are saying, oh, if we get the first round, don't jump too far. We've got a game to win tonight, and it's not going to be easy. But I think the way we're playing with the boys I've got in there, and Ron's touched on it earlier, with the attitude and the desire they've got, I think we've got a great chance.
Well, both sides got goals in them, so it's going to be a nil-niller. Fantastic. To the end. Guys, it's been great to have you with us. Enjoy the whole event, the whole evening, and may the best team win.